And so let us just spend a few minutes on bhava. And in fact, many sisters were also asking, brothers were also asking, how do we actually, you know, get bhava into our bhajan? We all love to, you know, spend a lot of time in technicalities. We listen to a lot of good singers. We want to pick up this, pick up that. But I think one thing that we cannot pick up from somewhere outside, and it has to come from within us, is bhava. And that is what Swami wants. Because outside, Swami would say is bahya priya. Swami says, I am not bahya priya, I am bhava priya, that which comes from inside. Right, we were just telling some of the young adults yesterday, you know, when somebody asked how to choose bhajans, we were telling them, right, that so your place in the heaven is not decided by the complicated nature of the bhajans that you choose. Okay, means if you choose a more complicated, means like someone, then someone like Ravi sir is alone guaranteed to go to, you know, heaven.
So now I have no guarantee.
You know, probably some, only like M.S. Subbalakshmi and Lata Mangeshkar, only they can go to heaven. Not possible. I mean, doesn't make sense, right? So Swami is looking at our bhava. How do we actually, you know, inculcate bhava, the proper bhava while singing? Swami says that while you may have any amount of food, all of that food makes, you know, it becomes, gets its taste only when you add salt to it. Otherwise, all other food is bland. Food without salt you cannot call it food at all. You may have any amount of, you know, olive oil, this parmesan cheese or cheddar cheese or whatever you add to it. If there is no salt to the food, Swami says, bhajans without bhava is like food without salt. Okay, you can decorate it as much as you want, but it is tasteless for the Lord. And we are giving it, these bhajans are our offering to the Lord for as His naivedyam. Right? So, bhava is that important.
In fact, Swami also says, all these songs or all these offerings are like the flowers in the garland. But you can't make a garland without a thread. You need something to string it all together. Swami says, bhava is that thread which strings things together to make a garland which is worthy of offering to the Lord.
So, you cannot see the thread. You can see only the flowers. So the outside world will only be able to see the, you know, the gamakas and our raga and tala. But the garland knows that it is being held together only because of the thread, and that is the bhava inside. So what are the different ways in which we can get bhava? One very simple but very powerful technique is this visualization. If I can just request brother to, so we have just put together, you know this particular tool, and you could probably do that in the mind's eye, or you can, because of technology today, you can even have that. So what is visualization is your ability to picturize, you know, the name and the form of the Lord as you're singing it. So let us take a bhajan like Jai Kailashapati Shiva Shankar. So I'll request our brother to sing, and you know, just pay attention, not to us, but to the screen behind us. Okay, and we've just put together a visualization for you on this particular bhajan called Jai Kailashapati Shiva Shankar. So imagine for a moment, as you're watching that in the mind's eye, all of us, let us transport ourselves to Kailash. And that is Kailash for you behind. Okay, the resident of that is Lord Shankara, Lord Shiva himself. And this bhajan is in propitiation to this Lord. So we have trekked all across for several days, and we are finally at the foothills of Kailash. And the heart says,
जय कैलाश पते शिव शंकर
एंड अलोंग विद द लॉर्ड इज द मदर
सांब सदा शिव शंभो
एंड ओ लॉर्ड वी आर सो हैप्पी that you have come all the way from Kailash to be our Sai Shiva.
Parteshwar Sai Shiva Shambho.
O Lord, you are the Lord of all the mountains, the entire Himalayas belong to you.
Shaileshwar Karunamay Shankara.
You're the repository of the entire cosmos, and you have shown it to us. We have seen it with our own eyes emerging from within you.
लिंगोद्भव कर शिव शंभो.
यू आर द वन हु होल्ड्स द त्रिशूला विच स्टैंड्स फॉर द त्रिगुणा द त्रिमूर्ति एंड द त्रिकाला.
त्रिशूल जटाधर गंगाधारी.
यू होल्ड मदर गंगा इन योर लॉक्स एंड जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ ऑल अस मैनकाइंड यू हैव टेकन द हला हला और द पॉइजन यू हैव ड्रंक दैट.
हला हल धर शंभो.
Our obeisance to you, O Mother and Father.
Sambha Sada Shiva Shambho Paritishvara Sai Shiva Shambho.
Welcome back to LA. I'm sure none of you want to come back, right? All of us want to be there. We want to be with our Lord in Kailash, in Prashanti Nilayam. So this is a very powerful tool, you know, and thanks to all the images that have been painted by all the great artists, we can bring that in front of us while the bhajan is going on. It's a very powerful technique. I use it a lot and, you know, I keep doing this. This is my favorite pastime. I keep making PPTs like this for different bhajans. So that it helps us to visualize better.
You must have heard even Kaushalyatmaja Ramacharan when he sang that. That was also a visualization, you know. Army of Vanaras behind him as he was singing that, yeah.
So. Right. So another technique to actually get bhava, right? I'm sure I see a few moist eyes over here. Isn't this a powerful technique? Can we not all practice this? Why will we not one day when we, instead of opening our eyes, we can close our eyes and we can pictureize this, right? The other technique is to know the meaning of the bhajan. And I think that is very critical in order to get bhava. If I were to hear a Spanish or a Chinese bhajan, I will not be able to get bhava. And in fact, I can tell you one thing, that if you know the meaning and if you totally go into the meaning of the bhajan, you probably will not be able to complete the bhajan because you will be crying. That is how powerful some of these words are. Just to give you a couple of examples, you know, do we know the meaning of Damodara? We know that Damodara means, it is Krishna's name. But do we know what is the meaning of Damodara? So very quickly, let me tell you, you know, Damodara comes from that particular incident when Yashoda was one day trying to tie Krishna to a tree. Okay, because he was all running around and so mischievous. And so it is said that Yashoda takes a thread, a rope, and she is trying to tie Krishna, and it so happens that she takes the rope and she tries to tie and it falls short by, it seems, only two fingers, you know, the length of two fingers. So she throws away the rope, she gets a longer rope, she tries to tie Krishna, okay, and once again falls short of two fingers. And this goes on several times. Whatever length of rope she takes, she's just not able to tie Krishna because it is always falling short by two fingers. And eventually, she just surrenders to him and she says, "What is this, Kanhaiya? I am not able to even tie you. You only tie yourself." You know, at that moment, she surrenders to him and then he himself takes and ties, you know, himself to the tree. And any length of rope is then sufficient. And then the Lord, in fact, the great saints, when they talk about this particular incident, they say that those two fingers stand for ahamkara and mamakara, attachment and ego. As long as Yashoda felt that, you know, she is my son and I can tie him, that attachment and ego, she was not able to tie him. The moment she surrenders to him and gives up those two fingers, then he says, now I will tie myself to you. Why are you worried? So the word Damodara, Udara means stomach and Dama means rope. So the rope which tied the stomach of the Lord, he is called Damodara. Now just imagine what a beautiful meaning when we sing this word, "Oh Lord, I want you, please tie yourself to me. Okay, allow me to be bound to you all the time." The second, another word, do we know the meaning of Janardana? We often say Janardana. What is the meaning of Janardana? Janardana means the one who bestows all types of boons. Okay, to all mankind. Janaha means mankind and Ardhana means to satisfy the boons of everybody. So now just imagine, let us take a bhajan, having known these the meaning of these words, just let us take a bhajan and let me run through, make a story. Once you are able to understand the meaning of the bhajan, then you can make a story along with the bhajan. This bhajan is a very well-known bhajan, Giridhar Govind Gopal, which brother will sing. I'll just take you through, because I remember one particular scene when, in fact, Ravi brother had played the role of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu many years back. And I was seeing the drama, it was way back in 1992, if I'm not wrong. And there's a beautiful scene from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life, the great saint Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, where he was a great Sanskrit scholar and he was bitten by the, what should I say, he was bitten by the scorpion of, maybe scorpion is a bad word, but he was bitten by the Lord's name. He suddenly forgot all his scholastic intelligence and started chanting the name of the Lord, and it is said that he started seeing Krishna everywhere. And there is one scene where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is inside the chamber and he sees Krishna behind one pillar, and he runs to hold Krishna and he hits his head to the pillar, and Krishna disappears and appears behind another pillar. And then he runs over there and he hits his head to that pillar, and Krishna disappears from there. Krishna is playing with his devotee, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is just running to the Lord. And at that moment, I felt that this bhajan encapsulates that feeling.
Giridhar Govinda Gopal Ghanshyam Nandalala.
It is like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu telling,
Giridhar Govinda Gopal,
where are you, Lord?
Ghanshyam,
there is so much of, you know, crying. Please give me your darshan.
Ghanshyam Nandalala.
And then the next line is,
Manamohana Madhusudana.
Please give me darshan.
Madhava.
And then the Lord does not appear for a long time, and so the heart cries out,
Damodara Janardana Murali Dhara Manamohana.
And when the heart calls out like this, the Lord has pity on you and he comes in front. And when he comes, he has come as the Vishnu Virata Swarupa. He's giving us darshan. And then when you see that magnificent form of the Lord, the heart goes,
Namo Sai Narayanaya, Namo Satya Narayanaya.
And that magnificent Lord is telling, my child, come, I have come for you. Come, take Pad Namaskar. And as we fall down at his feet, as we bow down to his feet, the heart says,
Namo Sai Narayanaya, Namo Sai Narayanaya.